The South Africa that I grew up in was a very schizophrenic, frustrating kind of place. They were, as white people, we were brought up with this incredible wealth and abundance. And then there were these millions of black people who had almost nothing, who were living on almost subsistence levels, and nobody was really admitting it. There was this, it was this complete denial. Generally, the idea that was being created was that we being white people, we were helping the black people come up to the modern Western level. But meantime, what was really happening is that black people were completely disenfranchised. They couldn't open businesses, they couldn't live where they wanted to, couldn't vote. They had absolutely no freedom of expression. My schoolmates seemed to believe that we were doing them some kind of a big favor. What we were doing was really cheating ordinary people out of their basic civil rights.
But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long suffering, goodness, gentleness, self control, faithfulness, patience, kindness, generosity.
And I used to argue and read the English newspapers and try and find evidence to show them. But of course, the white Afrikaner propaganda machine was very, very powerful. And so my little arguments that I had had absolutely no effect. I started kind of separating myself from my friends, from my environment. I was living in Johannesburg. It was a very tough period of my life. It was towards the end of apartheid. There was lots of horrible things happening, and we were living in an area where at night there were car chases and people shooting at each other, and we were drinking a lot, and some people were committing suicide. Some people were being murdered by the security police. We were very much on edge, and we didn't really know where or when or what, where to go. By the end of my school years, I was very, very frustrated. It was also the year that the revolution actually broke out into the open, and the kids started fighting the police in the streets.
Was it a huntsman or a player that made you pay the cost, that now assumes relaxed positions and prostitutes your loss? Were you tortured by your own thirst in those pleasures that you seek, that made you Tom the curious, that makes you James the weak? And you claim you got something going, something you call unique, but I've seen your self-pity showing as the tears roll down your cheeks.
Was this this wall of ignorance and conservatism, and the only way I could really deal with this conservatism is I started writing poetry, and I would sit at night and write poetry and put myself into weird trances. I started playing with hypnosis and putting myself into trances and then writing these absolutely horrific poems. I would have to go into the military, which I really didn't want to do, because basically the status quo in South Africa was enforced through the military, and I didn't want to become part of that at all. But there was no legal way in which one could get out of this. The day after I wrote my final exam at school, I hitchhiked down to Cape Town to be as far away from my environment as possible. I got a simple job at the railways, and at night I would draw and paint. I attended some art classes at the Cape Town Technicon. But mostly I was smoking a lot of cannabis sativa. I wasn't really mixing with anybody. I was just very much inside myself, drawing, painting, writing poetry, reading, and smoking my joints. Worrying about this thing of having to go to the army in 6 months' time. After 6 months, I took the train back to Pretoria. On the train station, my father walked straight past me. He didn't recognize me at all. Somehow I changed completely. and a couple of days later, I kind of flipped. 2 or 3 days before I was supposed to be conscripted into the military. And I started, I became quite psychotic. I was not sleeping. I hadn't slept for 5 or 6 days. And I was being very aggressive. I was verbally attacking everybody on their political and religious beliefs. And at first, my parents had me committed to a private hospital in Johannesburg. And then the military said, no, I have to go to a state hospital because they don't accept private doctors' opinions. Because of my interest in psychology, the madhouse, as I used to call it then, was a very interesting and bizarre place. And I had lots of totally over-the-top experiences in there. Everybody in the madhouse was smoking like crazy. But the one thing they all used to do is they used to look at the tip of the cigarette and really smoke it as if it was some kind of a lifeline. The bigger this flame was, the better. So after many years, lots of ups and downs, finally I found by accident the doctor in Pretoria who was actually treating artistic people, a psychiatrist with the name of Gefti Mare. And he said to me, look, I'm not interested in whether you wanted to fuck your mother or any other this kind of nonsense. I'm interested in the chemicals in your body. And he said that, okay, I'm going to give you different sets of drugs, and if you respond well, then you've got to take them, and if you don't respond well, then you've got to stop. And after 6 months, and he really drugged me silly, and it was during the first 6 months that I went to art school, it was pure hell. After 6 months, he said to me, I'm sorry, but you're responding really badly to these drugs. There's nothing wrong with you. I'm going to take you off these things now. Suddenly I had no more drugs, and my body freaked out completely. There were pains and things happening in it unimaginably. I was incredibly tortured. So this whole thing lasted plus minus 4 to 6 years. I was given electroshock therapy, which was quite a horror. I couldn't remember anything. By the end of a sentence, I couldn't remember the beginning of the sentence. I couldn't remember people that I'd met a couple of minutes ago. And then somehow somebody gave me a joint again. And snap! My memories all came back immediately. Eventually, one day, they had finally put me into work therapy, where I had to count matches and fill matchboxes. Each matchbox had to have 50 matches in it. And they said this was my rehabilitation. And then I just thought, no, this is too much. And I went to my locker, took my stuff, and I just thought, enough is enough. I walked straight out of the place and I hitchhiked, I don't know, 20 or 30 kilometers home. And I told my parents I'm not gonna go back there again.
And you claim you got something going, something you call unique. But I've seen your self-pity showing as the tears roll down your cheeks.